Say, welcome to the Perfect Match Podcast.
I'll say, welcome to the Perfect Match Phone.
Perfect Match Podcast.
Welcome. Whoa, a little flare at the end. That was serious.
I don't know. I don't know, man. Just how I felt about this episode. A little bit of flare at the end. That's what it was.
It was. It was dreadfully boring at the beginning.
Painfully boring.
Ooh.
I mean, it was...
The dirty pirate hooker love triangle did not pique my interest whatsoever.
You know what's boring? When you don't even, like, skip through the commercials. Like, the first commercial set, I was like, oh, okay, sweet. I'm excited to watch these.
Right. Oh, a little action.
Oh, a Skittles commercial? Don't mind that.
At least there's some story.
Yeah. But, I mean, it wasn't all terrible. It was just, whatever.
It was just, none of these are, like, age-old, like, back and forth, like, CT and DM or, like... You know, I don't know. I don't
None
care.
Of that. There
Johnny
wasn't like
and Angela pretending they like each other. I don't care. Like, they're both pretending to pretend to like each other for the challenge. And I don't care.
And it's a little too early. There was no night out. It's a little too early to have any, like, extreme shenanigans going on. Or, like, big drama. Like, two people who have hated each other the whole season. We're too early for that. So
yeah.
There's a lot of just joking around.
And the two people that did have an interesting vendetta, we saw them go into the elimination. So that was the little flare at the end.
Yeah. Exactly. That was like, I guess,
if there was any... That was that part.
Any sort of story to this episode, it was the Pauly storyline, I guess.
With Shane.
With Kyle. And...
Oh, it was Shane and Kyle, too. And Pauly and Shane. Or Pauly and Kyle. Yeah, sorry.
Shane was not even involved. They were just rehashing that.
But that was one of the most interesting parts.
Absolutely. I love Shane. I love him. I really appreciate him and Amanda's, like, little bond.
Agreed.
Their friendship. It's one of, like, they actually are, it seems, very close friends.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of rare on these shows. It's usually, like, you know, whatever. Your friends on the... Your show friends. You're not, like, real friends.
Yes,
you know?
And to that point, I feel like they're mostly the gay men and straight women that have those connections. Like, I almost confused Shane and, what is his name? Tyler. Tyler and Paula have friendship.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like, well, Frank is... And more of a sociopath than gay.
I think some of the girls have, like, legit friendships,
mm-hmm.
but the guys never
do.
I mean, unless it's, like, Evan and Kenny or, like, where you're
and
the
do
same
they even...
person. I don't know.
Yeah, who knows? I guess they do post.
But I just love that Shane, so they showed all of, like, him digging at Kyle with the, like, his beard and...
Fake beard? What does that look
fake
like?
Fake chin. And all that kind of stuff. But I just love that Shane, like, was just like, yeah, you know, I deserve him hating me.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, I gotta deal with that now. Like, it's like, whoops, I got drunk and, like, called him out on all this mm-hmm. kind of surface stuff.
And he was basically like, because I like him.
it's so good, and Shane is so essential to, like, just driving the show along.
I mean, yeah, I agree. I do agree. Okay.
And then, I don't know if we had any other, like, house drama.
I guess we were going to save it for after, but the one thing I thought was funny was in the Pauly, Kyle,
love triangle
Cara,
thing. Yeah.
But then with Faith, when Kyle is in Faith's bed, and then he's in the interview and he's like, can you make me look like a stupid idiot rather than a dickhead?
It was so raw.
Yeah, him saying that, I was just like, I appreciate you, Kyle, for that.
And, like, we've had Kara on as, like, the token pirate for years.
Oh,
and Kyle is now, like, advancing. He's like, hold my beer, Kyle. Or Kara. I'm the pirate. The bloody pirate.
Kyle, Kara, Brittany, and Chuck. Pirates. Brittany and Chuck just because they're so filthy.
How about Marie calling out Kara for that? Like, I don't like Kara because she's entitled. And I don't like her because she doesn't wash her hair. But honestly, as we're watching the show, it's like, Kyle doesn't wash his hair. Kara does not. Brittany and Chuck were just filth grease balls.
Filth. Trash. Just
yelling at each other. And
Jenna for sure washes her hair every day, no matter what. I feel like she washes and straightens her hair.
Oh, yeah.
No matter what, every day for the rest of her life.
Her hair looked like it could have been on a L'Oreal commercial.
Yeah.
Compared to Chuck and Brittany, who are sitting 5 feet from her.
Brittany's hair's like, it looked like a wax figure of like a surfing wave to the side. It was like sticking straight up and not moving an inch.
It was so
disgusting. Probably smelled like beer.
I know, and it seems like it's always like that, right?
Yeah. In that house, at least.
What is with this stuff?
I mean, you gotta just...
I guess it's just...
Some people on vacation just want to be filthy. Some people don't like showers. I don't understand those people. I always look filthy because my hair is just mermaids. Like, it's been under the sea forever for some reason, but... I have to take a shower. Like, showers are the best.
Chuck's hair looked like it had not been showered in 4 days.
I know.
Which is too much.
So
if
gross.
It looks like somewhat greasy because like you worked out and you didn't shower, whatever. It's one thing.
His and it's cold there, clearly.
I have no idea what temperature it is.
Yeah.
It's like the middle of the day, CT and Bananas are out on the deck wearing beanies. And then like an hour later, they're like sun tanning.
They were laying up at the pool. And then at the elimination, everyone's bundled up for winter.
So weird.
Yeah. My dad was here watching it with us, and he's also listening, and he couldn't get over it. He was like, why is it cold? Like, why are they in a cold place?
But, it is so mysterious. Are they just like, here's what I think it is. No, I don't know. I don't even know what it is. Because
that was weird.
Well, because I was thinking like, oh, they probably, their house is in the mountains, and then their challenges are on the beach or something.
But they're.
But also their house, in back-to-back scenes in their house, they were bundled up then by the pool.
Yeah. Poolside.
So, I don't know. Kind of bizarre. I really quickly want to sneak in a Sarah tweet. Let's Get Social. She said, 100% of CT's in-house content is before 11 a.m. with him drinking coffee out of an abnormally large container, staring off across the property, and talking to someone who has been placed by production who is at about 25% of their normal energy level. Like, that's absolutely what it is. But I don't know if that's like...
the most astute observation I've heard in years.
Yeah. And we've
multiple
joked...
years.
We've joked on this pod before about CT with his coffee, just like... That's like his, I don't know, it's like Tony with a bottle of booze in his hand is just CT sitting bags under his eyes with a coffee.
Just the most puffy eyes you've ever seen.
It's just his, like, state. Uh-huh. His constant state on the show. And
Though his kid isn't even there.
Yeah, but I kind of get it, though. As, like, as a dad, that's when you're, like, 7 to 11 on a weekend is, like, the most productive time.
Yeah.
You make your coffee, you get your playing in with your kid, you're, like, doing dishes, and then 11 hits, and you're just, like, you're done. You're done.
Mm-hmm.
Can't go anymore. So that I get it. I get it with CT.
And I love that that tweet by Sarah.
It's fantastic.
That was so good.
Fantastic. So after all of this... drama, a lot of mild
about
drama.
The elimination.
And the nomination,
voting.
The voting, all
love
that.
Love the
of
secret
stuff.
Vote. Okay,
so
they're melding Are You the One technology wise. And bringing it to. Well, I mean, at first, I said this out loud, but I'll say it again. I thought when they were going down as teams that there were like wax figurines of everyone that they were looking at. It was like overkill, but it was just an optical illusion, and
it
was just a picture.
And
it
might have even been like stuff that was edited in after the fact, like the actual pictures were edited in after the fact.
Yeah.
No, but they're fine. They're like, yeah, I don't know. Taking, I don't know if "Are You the One" is the right comparison that they're taking, but
the light up squares.
The light up squares was very "Are You the One"-ish for sure.
Yeah, the wax museum in the basement was more of like from whatever that bullshit truth booth. Poor man's truth booth in the basement.
Yeah,
Shack of Secrets.
Shack. Yes. Yeah. Yes. 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 It is.
What's the show that we just
did? X on the Beach.
Oh my God! Thank you.
Shack of Secrets.
I'm like losing my mind.
I love the secret votes. I love that.
Should have been doing it years ago.
Years ago, and I love the teacher who goes, "No more burner votes. No more bullshit."
Mm-hmm.
And my one gripe with it is like, do we need to show every single person going in there and arguing for 5 minutes over like who they're choosing?
The answer is no.
We don't. And I didn't care about a single one of those things.
Mm-mm.
Not even Cara and Marie. Yeah.
Cara Marie.
Who disagreed. I don't even care. Just do the voting. Show a little montage of them going in and out, mm-hmm, voting quickly, mm-hmm, and then.
Or just we get
it. To it. Yeah.
Yeah. Just show them like looking at the wax figures and then
that's
get us out there.
That's all we need to know.
But I have a question about it. Like, when TJ then has them light up to show who voted for who, so do we waste all our money on the wax figurines? And the jig is
wax
up.
Wax figurines.
I know, but
two screens.
Jig is up. Because they know it's not secret. So are we going to go through the charade?
No, that still makes sense to me, though. Because,
what?
Well, they're not secret anymore, but it is a blind vote. You're not.
So
you're
the element to. If, like, who you vote for, because you don't want the person you vote for to actually go in, necessarily. Because then you're going to be outed for who
exactly.
you vote for. Unless
like,
it's like a
like we
layup.
Could, we could get some, like, massive burn votes where it's, like, 7 people get votes, 1 person gets 2 votes, mm-hmm, and then they have to pick between the two.
That's going to happen for sure.
It's like Russian roulette.
That's going to happen for sure.
And, like, you still. The best part about the secret voting, or the blind voting, is that you're not. God, so often in these things, it's like whatever the first person says, it just runs with it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so annoying.
Yeah.
And it's so dependent on like, well, Johnny, you pick first.
Right.
Or like, well, Kara, you pick first. It's like, why are these same people picking all the time? Why isn't like the rookie picking first?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because it's like whoever sits on the end, that, you know how you would count in church to see who you would sit by your friends?
Yes.
Like, oh, don't, like, can you cut me? Because otherwise we're going to be on the end of a row. We're going to, like, split.
Yeah.
That is the same, like, thing. Like, all right, just sit on the end. Like, sit in that seat. Because he always picks the person in that seat.
Like, get up slowly so that you're the last person to get into the line.
Lock eyes with him when he says that we're about to vote. It's like, is that how it goes? Who knows?
Yeah, and it turns into this fucking snowball effect of like,
all right, well, they're all gonna pick him. It's like basically only the first vote counts.
Exactly. And this is
unless
no longer,
someone
no
needs
more.
To save their friend, and then it's drama. But mm-hmm. Yeah, that's no more burn votes, no more bullshit. We got it. That's perfect.
It's fantastic.
It is. It's excellent. It needed to be that
and
way.
I even though like they could have just done that, and that probably would have been enough. Then to have, like, if you vote someone in, be prepared to take them out.
Yes.
It just puts everyone on the line. There's, like, literally no alliances.
Right, because if the second you get voted in, you can be called right back out.
Yeah, so
it's perfection.
It, like, it obviously favors winning. Brad and Kyle had such an advantage not even being in that mix.
And getting 2 votes.
It also favors being good at eliminations, which, like, a lot of seasons don't. And it favors, like, just kind of, I don't know, being, like, the middleman, like, not making waves with people.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like Tori and Derek could just, like,
close to the end.
Yeah. Just because no one will. They're good competitors, not great.
They're
no
just,
one's going to pick them because they hate them, but, you know.
They're working their shit out on the side. She's Jordan's girl. And, like, the fact that he's not there almost makes it more like they want to protect her. At least Jordan's friends.
Yeah,
I don't know who they are.
Does Jordan have friends?
I think he does, but I don't think any of them.
Probably not show friends. He seems like he's way over any of these characters.
I guess you're right. You're
maybe
so
like
right.
People back in like the
I
rivals
about that. We didn't
days.
Watch last season's. Well,
the champs versus
whatever when he was on the reunion. I like remember barely paying attention to that whole mess. But anyways, we are on another track. I wanted to say, what is the... Okay, so I love Armageddon. Armageddon Elimination.
Mm-hmm.
It should be called Epcot Armageddon. That's what it looks like. But then when we saw the preview, it was like the apocalypse, final reckoning, Armageddon.
I know.
We get
it. It's just another name.
We fucking get it.
At least they don't have the Troika and...
Oh, I know.
The... What was it? It was the deliberation where they had to sit and eat dinner with the people. That was so...
No, what was it called? It wasn't deliberate. Was it called the deliberation?
I think it was called the deliberation, where like the three people that they selected, they then got to eat dinner with. It was like so ridiculous.
Yeah, it was like, yo, there was one season where they were like obsessed with the dinner because the food was shit, but like now...
But I also liked that one because it was like they got to pick someone, they could call multiple people there, just like chat. Like, I enjoyed that.
Right.
It was a lot more casual. Didn't have a name. It was like, it was always Johnny and Sarah because they won like every challenge. It was always like them eating pizza, like, hey, Nani, come over here.
Right.
Hey, Zach, come over here.
I remember Nani. Like, I remember their meeting.
It was perfect.
It was way better.
And but
this one, yeah, just get rid of the dinner.
But now they have the wax figures, so.
I'm okay with the wax figures as long as next time we know that they know it's not a secret. So just get them in, get them out.
Yeah.
And then we got Think Outside the Box. Killa Kam, really into being Killa Kam.
Really into the Killa. She loves the persona. She's like a wrestler who like finally got her time to shine. She finally like... got a huge pop, went over, and this is her persona now.
Yeah.
Killa Kam, and she just wants to sell t-shirts. That's all she wants to do.
No, I don't.
She wants the WWE title belt.
Okay,
I'm saying, like,
say,
as a wrestler.
Oh. But then I loved that at the end of that, and there's so much more I want to quickly say, put in about Kam, because she's just so great to me.
Mm-hmm.
When she says, like, it's time for, or it's Killa Kaylee time. Like, kind of gave, and she was just like genuinely happy, like gave it over, you know?
Oh my god, this is such a wrestling thing.
Oh.
Because so often, like,
they do
they'll combine two random people in a tag team, and they'll take the, like, more popular person's, like, persona and name and apply it to both of them.
Let me ask you this.
What?
Glow is a show now.
Yeah.
Do you think that's where Killa Kam is headed? The Miz's tracks.
Oh. I mean, I could see it. She's got the persona. That'd be awesome.
She really does. And so, but also, the fact that she was saying, when she first mentioned Killa Kam, mm-hmm. Killa Kam, where are you, girl? Time to come out. It's like, you don't even know where she is. You are her.
It's
you
so bring good. Her out. It's like great. It's like a whole shtick.
I get you, and you get me. We see each other,
mm-hmm.
and I love her.
She's here. She's here.
Right. She just makes me so happy. She makes me happy.
Wait, really quick. Not
no,
sketchy.
No, not really quick. Take your time.
Not sketchy production corner. More like, ooh, yee, production what? Corner. Because you mentioned The Miz. His show is also on Tuesday nights, same time as The Challenge.
Oh, Miz.
Miz and Mrs. I think that's what it is. Mrs.
Is he
and
married?
Miz. Yeah, it's his show with his wife on E.
Ooh.
It's like a spinoff of Total Divas. But...
Or, Hogan Knows Best.
I don't think so. No, but like, that's kind of a shady move by Miz. I know he has no choice in when they show his show, but to conflict directly with the show that brought him to prominence, kind of a...
It's a bitch move.
It's something.
You're a bitch, Miz. We already knew it.
It's actually E. He's a bitch.
He's a bitch. Yeah. Truth.
So, that was my little production corner.
Who said that? okay, then one last thing we have to talk about. This is going to be a quick...
The bungee?
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
The bungee taut level.
And there's a couple levels of this that I want to talk about.
All right, go for it, because I want to just hear.
Okay, so bungee... Pauly's bungee was clearly tighter than Cam's. It was evident in watching it. I know, but I'm just laying it out there. Clearly tighter than Cam's, which is fine.
Duh.
They obviously need to do that. They can't have them... He can't just, like, be strolling over there, picking up these pieces,
And if willy-nilly. It was as tight as hers, she... Like, if it was tight for him, for it to be hard for him, she would not ever make it.
She wouldn't have gotten a single brick.
I think that they genuinely had those things mapped out beforehand, and that's just the way the cookie crumbled. It didn't look like it was easy for Cam.
What do you mean?
Yeah, like, it did.
Like, it wasn't easy for her. It was still a little bit difficult, but it was extremely more difficult for Polly. Anyways, and that's...
They have to do that kind of shorter bungee, too.
They have to do that kind of stuff to even this out with these mixed teams. It is bothersome.
But do you think that Cam is stronger for a girl than Polly is for a guy? That's really what it comes down to.
Yes, I do think so.
Okay, then so that, probably fair.
That's probably a wash. So that's kind of my first aspect of it, is that... So I wonder then if, like, in a future challenge, production should just, like... All right, Polly, you can't be on the bungee. We have to have two girls doing the same task. So you have to do, like, a team like Polly and Natalie. Well, they're out, but, like, what's another guy-girl team? Tori and Derek.
Yeah.
If they're going up against two girls, like, Tori has to do the physical thing against the other girl, and the guy has to do the mental thing against the other girl.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with two guys. And I just wonder... Now, two guys against two girls, it would obviously have to come up with some sort of different other challenge. Or they could still do this thing. I just wonder if they'll, like, do that differently. Because could have just done Natalie, you have to do the bungee. Paul, you have to do the puzzle because of the way the teams are set up.
For real, though, they should have had Natalie do the puzzle. Or the bungee. Because they would have probably won.
Now, and that was going to be my third part of it. I wonder if these teams now are going to see how Paulie struggled at that, realize... They're going to make this a lot tougher for the guys. Let's have the girls do the more physical aspect because it evens the playing field.
Great point, and you're probably right. And I'm 100% at peace with Polly and Natalie being the sacrificial lambs.
Same. Absolutely. And no qualms with that.
Zero.
I mean, they're great.
And it really, I do just, it made me uncomfortable. I couldn't get my head out of thinking about the tightness of their bands. And so I was like, I wish, like, I was mad that I had to, like, think about that at all.
I know, I couldn't even enjoy.
I was like, this is too easy for Cam. Like, that's what it looks like. I'm annoyed.
They're winning already. Polly's struggling. Oh my
Polly's
gosh.
Thing is broken. It's too tight. They're not going to stop. Like, it's not fair. He can't actually move the pieces. That's what it seemed like.
Yeah.
It was annoying and just took me out of it. But
and, like, we got that Killa one out Kam, of the way. They were the gerbils, the
as
hamsters.
As she said, her elimination record now matches her her GPA. 4.0. God, I love her so much.
She's great. The charisma oozes mm-hmm. out of her.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, a WWE, you may be onto something, Rand.
Well, you pretty much said it.
Yeah, but you made the claim.
All right, I'll take it.
Yeah. Should we do a little bit of Let's Get Social before wrapping up?
Let's get social.
Social. God, I want to watch that video again. I haven't watched it.
We should share it on our Twitter.
Yeah, I will. I will, for sure. Speaking of Natalie and Polly, we didn't talk about this, but Natalie came out as pansexual.
Pans.
Addressed all the Twitter stuff with Kaylee. Sarah was ecstatic.
Oh, yes.
Said, like, come on down, Natalie. The water's fine.
I love
and
it.
Later, she was like, my queen, and retweeted, like, the e-story.
I want to read it. You always check the notifications before I
She can. Just that. She just sent that to us. I didn't even have time to read it.
Oh, so she just came out.
Well, Natalie came out last week.
Last week.
Yeah.
Got it.
But,
Oh, right. We missed last week. Sorry, guys.
Full disclosure. If you made it this far, we didn't watch last week.
Ooh. I love that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. It's fantastic. And not often... the fact that it was... She was incorrectly outed and outed.
Right.
On, like...
There's no correctly...
the show.
There's no correctly outed.
Well, she was...
Unless you come out, and then you're not outed.
Natalie, Kaylee outed her as a lesbian, but she's not even a lesbian, she's pansexual.
Got you.
Not only was she outed, she was incorrectly labeled when she mm-hmm. was outed. So, the fact that she...
came out on her own. It's
just, or was able to, like, address this question. Powerful thing. It's great.
What is worse? What? Oh, wait, never mind.
What Katie did or what Natalie did?
Natalie didn't do anything. I was thinking Natalie threw the thing over.
How about that clip?
Wow.
Kate, you know, Natalie was there, so...
Just as much in it.
Just as
much. She was in the background holding her face.
Shocked.
Wow, I forgot about that. Yeah.
She probably gave Kaylee a hug after.
Honestly.
Isn't that so weird?
Wow. Here in my head while watching it, I'm like picturing Natalie being Killa.
Yeah.
And I can't believe myself right now.
Killa. Yeah,
dude,
you have Killa and
Natalie should have
Brittany.
Won. I should have been cheering for her.
Oh, I know. But it was tough. It was Killa Kam versus...
Talk about a reach for vindication, Kaylee.
Oh my god.
You're not vindicated. Natalie had nothing to do with it. Now you just have more shit on your plate.
I gotta
now
say,
you're
I do,
guilty.
I rarely commend the production on this show, but I commend them for showing Natalie just like she was so involved and her in the background clearly not doing a single
anything.
Thing.
Actually in shock at what she was seeing.
I guess
she was upstairs at the time.
I guess Kaylee was right in saying that Natalie was there. Because I think that's all she said. She was there. Well, okay.
She was just
so
as much there as everyone else. Yes. Well, true. Nobody was...
You were just as much there as everyone else.
Right. Everyone in the house was just as much there.
So stupid.
Ridiculous. Okay, any more?
And then Jamie said, I can't believe you guys compared Kara to not only Sophia the First, but also a snow cone. When can I expect Dr. McStuffins' Corner? Also dying that you knew Brother for Sale from Mary Kate and Ashley, because I thought I was the only one who remembered.
No, we got you. We got you, girl.
That's the only thing I remember about Mary Kate and Ashley besides Full House. And
remember when Mary Kate was on Weeds?
No, I didn't watch Weeds, and that was not like a thing for me.
No.
I remember, what was it? New York Minute? That was their one
movie.
Yes,
it was Eugene Levy.
I didn't watch it, but I remember we had the DVD of it. And it was like, I remember as like a probably 10-year-old going through our DVDs. Because like, DVDs came out when I was like 7. That's when they were like, so at 10 we had, our family had probably like 30 of them. And I remember being like, New York Minute. I think that's the only one I haven't watched. Because I would literally go like DVD by DVD and watch every bonus feature. Like some of them had games on them.
Yes, I remember.
We had the
those.
Snow White DVD. That was the first one we ever got.
You watched Snow White?
I hate Snow White, but for some reason I think it came with our DVD player. I honestly think it did. And there was a game where you were the dwarves and you were like going through a mine cart and you had to like answer Disney trivia questions along the way. It was so low technology, but being able to do that with my remote and as a 7-year-old, there's
10.
Nothing more I could ask for.
Oh no, you were 7.
It was fantastic.
Like, we are in the future, people.
Oh my gosh. We were there. And then, like, how about a DVD
And I'm only 7. This is awesome.
And then oh my god, I'm going way deep. Can I keep going with this? Is this too annoying? I guess it's a short pod anyway.
Anyways, yeah.
If you're still listening now, I'm going to keep going. There was a website, someone might know this, where you could find Easter eggs in your DVDs. So it would be like you would go down the menu and go left at a random option, and it would show like a deleted scene from the movie.
Wait, now I want to see which ones we have. Does Tangled have one?
Well, that's another thing is like these companies, the DVD, I don't know if it was like production companies like Disney or like whatever actual, probably studios. They at first were like, wow, these DVDs, we have menus, we have bonus features, we can add so much stuff to it. And then they realized like over time, no one watches these things.
Nope.
We're just going to have the movie, scene selection, subtitles. That's all we need.
Yeah. Stop wasting your time, people.
We don't need Easter eggs and dwarf games on everything.
People don't want the good stuff anymore. They have iPhones.
Definitely.
The good
internet.
Stuff.
The internet killed the DVD bonus feature game.
That's really the one downside
God damn
of the internet. Fucking
internet. Oh my gosh. I'm going to go look for some Easter eggs after this.
Please.
Yeah.
I want to see.
Those are our only tweets.
Yeah. And then the last thing was Fashion Corner. Brad's hair looks like a BMX track. In his interview.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Oh, wait. One more tweet. I just remember. I just saw it.
Oh.
Because Sarah sent this to us, that Johnny Bananas was on a plane, and, like, he said, "Hey, American Air, the same flight attendant who told me to drink bathroom water and refuses to provide her name is now trying to intimidate me by handing me this piece of paper." And it was like, "Your actions may be in violation of federal law," and, like, listed all these, like, potential things, disruptions that he could have been doing that he needed to, like, watch out for.
What was he doing?
Well, so he got handed that piece of paper. He said, "I didn't know American Air employees employ mob-style tactics in order to enforce passenger silence." Like, trying to, like, I don't know. People loved tweeted airlines. And so someone tweeted at him a screenshot of a text they received from someone on the flight. "Johnny Bananas from MTV's Real World and the Challenge was on our flight and raised all kinds of hell because he asked one of the flight attendants for water literally while we were taking off, and she asked him to wait. You'd swear she killed his dog." So fucking dramatic.
Wow. Receipts.
Just, oh my gosh. So
eyewitness
good.
Receipts.
I mean, how about getting that text? Fantastic. And then to see Johnny complain about it? So good. And fantastic. Sarah just said, "I'm cackling with glee at his entitlement."
Yes, I saw that, actually.
It's.
But I didn't see the next one.
Yeah.
I didn't see the text.
Yeah, it is juicy. Juicy, juicy.
Ooh.
So.
There we go.
On the hot seat, even though not really, because he has his own show now.
Oh, it's going to be god-awful.
It'll be done by Christmas.
Also, the bananas they put in the promo, like, shot are right in his crotch, and they look ridiculous. The, like, picture show?
Well, it's funny to have bananas in your crotch.
Maybe one banana. It looks like you're a freak.
I don't know. He's got multiple penises.
Honestly, like, okay. Keep it locked up, bananas.
Oh, man.
I just don't like that dude at all.
I'm interested to see that show.
Shorts hiked up. Talking to Angela. Angela, don't stick with Tarai. I can't believe I pulled his name out of my ass right now.
I couldn't
remember the name of the show 20 minutes ago.
Let alone the one person who wasn't on a previous show who was on there. I saw him, because we follow him on Twitter. He tweeted something, and it took me like 45 seconds. Like,
to translate it?
No, to like, I was like, okay, I need to know, who is this? We follow them. We must know who he is. And I like refused to click on his thing to like get further info.
Like, I know it.
He's got to be someone.
The apostrophe didn't give it away.
It just took me so long. I had already forgotten.
If you had a gun to my head and asked me to remember his name, I wouldn't have. But it just slipped out. Angela and Tarai. It's like Romeo and Juliet.
It is. You know, they're gonna be on the next. He'll be on the next challenge with her.
Hopefully, he's going to be good.
Yeah.
If he was on it,
he would be good.
All right, on that note, should we nip it?
Yeah, let's nip it.
We'll be
back.
We're
in the process of our Are You the One deep dives.
Yeah, we did a couple last night.
We're recording them as we go. And they're good stuff.
We'll see how it goes. It's a different tactic. It might be all choppy.
Oh, yeah.
The next one, we'll just do a straight through. I was just beyond tired.
Yeah, and they're long. They're in-depth. They're good stuff. So, August 15th, Woo! ATYO. Saw the trailer tonight.
Bria is my
different
girl.
Vibe.
Isn't she?
Yeah, she is.
Yeah, I got Bria.
She
just was the star of that.
She's the star of the trailer.
Yeah.
It's good. That's a good omen for her.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. We'll be back
next
week.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Probably.
Thanks for listening. Yeah. Keep tweeting at us.
Bye.
I was walking through icy streams that took my breath away. Moving slowly through westward water over glacial plains, and I walked off you, and I walked off an old